In this episode, I'll be designing and building these tiny stepper motor drivers for the Adafruit Feather. To start off, I'll design the circuit board schematic in Eagle. It uses four Polaloo DRV8835 driver carriers. Next, I'll design the board layout. Here, I'll place the parts on the board and let the auto router connect them together. It's a two-sided board with two stepper motor drivers on either side. On the back of the board, there's a power connector and an exposed input, just in case I want to connect a LED or a sensor or something like that. Now I'll switch to the manufacturing view where you can preview what your board will look like. My circuit board manufacturer has requested the files to be in RS274X format, so just remember to set that in your export settings. I've uploaded the Gerber files to PCBWay, and about 2 weeks later the boards have arrived. Links to the Gerber files are in the description. If you'd like to make your own, they're about $5 for 10 boards plus shipping. This is the layout of where the components will go on the board. On one side I have two pin headers, and then I have the two DRV8835 Polaloo stepper motor drivers. Then the ESP32 feather will sit on top. Next up, I'll prepare the DRV8835 carriers for surface mount soldering. To do this, I'll get a pair of side cutters and cut along the pinholes on either side. This way it'll be easier to solder it to the pads below. The first thing I'll solder are the female headers. To do this, I've cheated and super glued them down first. I'll do the same with the drivers and super glue them down first before soldering them. To solder the driver carriers, just heat up the connection and make sure there's a solder bridge between the board and the pad below it. Repeat the same steps for the second driver carrier, and if you want to as well, you can repeat the same steps for the other side of the board to add an additional two channels to the board. Or if you want to save a bit of money, you can just leave it as the two channels on the one side of the board. On the top of the board, there's a little solder joint. If you'd like to power the ESP32 from the power connector at the back of the board, just solder this joint together. Otherwise, you'll have to power the ESP32 and the stepper board with separate power supplies. Next up, I'm soldering the stepper driver board and the ESP32 together. I'm doing this to save a bit of space, but if you'd like to be able to separate them at a future stage, solder female pin headers to one side and male pin headers to the other side. Next up, I'll make a few small modifications to the ESP32. Removing this 4.7K resistor will disable the lithium polymer battery charger on this board. I'm doing this because I'll be using nickel metal hydride AAAs and I don't want the LiPo charger active. Next up, I'll remove the JST battery connector. I'm just doing this because it's fairly tall and it takes up a bit of extra space. To remove it, just heat up the pins on the side. And then heat up the pins on the back of it. Also clean up the solder pads a bit when I'm finished. Now you're ready to hook up power, motors, start programming it, and then build things.